Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Olga Onuzola Nulink, and before I start, I'm speaking in this soft tone because I love it. It's a loving frequency, and that's what I want to share with you. But also, both my man, my little man, and my big man are sleeping, so we'll see how this goes. And second of all, what do you think about my adornment of today? You know, a funny part of spiritual mom life, my spiritual mom life, my divine feminine lifestyle is that the list of the stuff that I need to do is humongous and sometimes overwhelming. And to be honest, there is so much of my stuff that I still need to reorganize, and I just opened up another bag of old garments that I haven't organized yet, and I found these, which brought me back to my older pre-mom styles, which I'm reintegrating right now. And the topic of a spiritual mom life is the most important one that I'm going to share with you guys, and I'm also here to connect with both women and men. Men, know that you are welcome also for my services. But I'm focusing the most to my sisters, to my divine goddesses. So let me know in the comments if you are a divine sister goddess, and if you are also stepping into your goddess divine self, your divine lifestyle daily, and if you are interested in creating a life full with ritual and feminine cycles. Every week we are different. It's not just our menstruation that makes us different. Every week we are different. Our life is so magical, and I want us to reintegrate the ritual and the feminine aspects. And another thing, if you are from the Netherlands, if you're listening to this and you're from the Netherlands, please leave a comment below, because I want to know where my viewers are coming from. And if you're from outside of Netherlands, you can also leave a comment below just to let me know. Because I'm retargeting my clientele, divine clients group. It's still rolling. Oh, the battery. I need to... This. Just 1 second. I think it's cut that out. The charger is in. So where was I? Yes. So, what did I want to share today? Spiritual mom life, divine feminine lifestyle. And by connecting with each other, sisters, and by re-exploring ourselves and what it means for us to be women, and to feel safe around each other to talk about what womanhood means for us. It's important for us to know who we are, what we are, so we can communicate this with our men. If we don't know, how can they possibly ever know? You know? And my work is for mass healing, and I'm focusing the most on my sisters, but men need healing too, and men are welcome as well to heal, because they too need to re-explore and remember who they are and their divine masculinity, so that we can harmonize together, so that we can come together in our natural divine state. So that was a bit of a pre-info. But there was something particular that I have a list of things that I want to discuss on my YouTube channel, because all these ideas keep coming to me, but I'm finding more and more time to express them. Yes, there were two things that are connected. Anxiety about time, why we feel rushed, but also the dark ages. I wrote down in Dutch, but did people know that they were living in dark ages? No. Later, when the dark ages were in the past, people described that time as dark ages. I believe that right now we are living in not the end, but I'd say the beginning of the end of the dark ages. And how do we step out of that? No, first I want you to reconnect with perspective of time, a bird's eye perspective of time. Imagine that you're hovering in the galaxy, in the universe, high in the sky, and you're watching the Earth and the movement of Earth and aeons of time. So not just decades or hundreds of years, but thousands of years. These have cycles as well of creating and building, blooming times, but also of withering and decay and destruction and dark times. And every time after a dark time, there comes another time where we rebuild our society, rebuild our empires, however you want to call it. And that makes this a very interesting time to live in, because we are the people that are moving in this beginning of the end of the dark times, the new dark times, and we have the opportunity to build the new. So think about, how do you want the world to be? And do not underestimate yourself, beautiful one. Do not underestimate yourself. Do not think that what you do doesn't have an impact and an influence on the world, because it does. It's such a cliche, but it's so true to say that a better world starts with yourself. I don't know if you say that in English, by the way, but we say it in Dutch. Beter wereld begint bij jezelf. How do you want the world to be? And master your mind. I speak about that a lot. What else? And let me know in the comment section what your thoughts are on this subject. Let us connect. Do not be afraid to comment. I don't know what else I wanted to share to you. Today we are slowly emerging from these times of greed, ignorance, and arrogance into a journey towards the divine. There's another topic. Het is jouw schuld niet. And why did I write this down? It's not your fault. I want to guide you out of the feeling of guilt. And I want to guide you out of a false responsibility. And I want to take this moment. This is very spontaneous, because I wasn't planning to do this in this video, but I want to do a small meditation and help you if you need to step out of guilt and false responsibility to free yourself, simply by focusing on some wounds and acknowledge painful experiences that you've been through that you pushed through or maybe oppressed and put away? And I feel that it's important to acknowledge that it's not your fault. Things have been done to you, injustice, unfair, and you're allowed to express that and call on justice to set the record straight, and also to call on your higher self and your power and your sovereign being, your divine self, to grant yourself, allow yourself to transcend the victimhood. But it's important to acknowledge the pain, and it's not your fault that things went the way they went. And it's even not the fault of the people that put the blame on you or that have oppressed you, because they are broken too. They experienced things, they were raised a certain way. Right now is the time to do better. What else? What comes to you now? Are there thoughts or memories that come up right now? We can also do personal consult if you want to. Lighten up your heart and express what needs to be expressed. Because I feel myself moving into the world of feelings more than into the world of words. You know, for a lot of things, words don't even exist. The world is very feminine. It's not your fault. There are reasons why it happened, and it's important to acknowledge that, to look at those reasons, so that from today on you can do it in a different way. You can decide to do it in a different way. And every day, step by step, it will be better, it will get better, you will get stronger, you will be able to remain more calm. I'm going to pull a card. From the Wildwood Tarot, 1, 2, 3, the energy of the Empress, North, East, South, West, and all its elements. Eight of Arrows, struggle. But you know what? It came in reversed. Do you believe the possibility that the struggle is over? You know, when you experience struggles after struggles, and even if you master your mind and focus on the good and believe that better times are coming, then more struggles will appear, and then Sometimes you're so used to the struggles that you unconsciously expect them. But what if you would expect miracles and you would expect good news? I have quite some experiences where I started expecting good news and it literally came true. This house is one of the many things that I expected. I visualized it. You know, if you don't believe in magic, it doesn't exist. If you believe in magic, it exists. If you believe that you can create, you can. If you don't believe that you can create with your mind, it will never happen. Believe in yourself. Next oracle card, Beyond Lemuria. Isn't it beautiful? Also, sisters, if you're still watching this, when I was taking a shower, I was thinking about doing sister circles where we don't have a schedule, where we honor our chaos. Not that we're gonna be chaotic, but we just take time to let things unfold at that moment. And let me know if you're near, if you live near me in the north of Holland and you are interested in those type of sister circles so that we can actively honor and live in our feminine cyclical and sometimes chaotic lifestyle so that we can feel the womb space, the darkness in which we can create, in which we are safe. So we have two cards. Loving compassion was in reversed. But no, I'm not gonna do the oracle cards in reversed. But maybe there, for some of you, there have been blockages. Loving compassion, life force energy. It is true that when there's a lack of loving compassion, it can be very draining. And that is a true responsibility that we have to really, every day, be loving and compassionate towards ourselves and towards each other, because that is such a powerful fuel for the life force energy. When you talk about loving things, compassionate things, beautiful things, it vitalizes you, it feeds you. And you know, many of these things are so sometimes cliche, but nonetheless they're very powerful. Life force energy. What gives you the life force energy? Water with lemon? Abundance. This was it for today. Divine Sister Goddess, I invite you to connect with me. And don't forget to leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. And lastly, to everybody, it's not your fault. Because remember that you have the ability when you have the power and the love in your heart to change your life and to do better every day, step by step. Take it easy now. Have a good one.